Gout is a clinical syndrome characterized by hyperuricemia and recurrent acute arthritis. What is uric acid? Uric acid is the end product of purine catabolism. Increase in blood uric acid level more than 7 mg per deciliter is called hyperuricemia. Chronic hyperuricemia leads to renal stone formation and deposition of monosodium urate crystals into joints. This leads to chronic inflammation and arthritis of joints, especially big toe. Now coming to types of gout, there are two types of gout based on the cause: primary gout and secondary gout. Primary gout, it is due to increased synthesis of purines, and this is because of mainly abnormal enzymes which are concerned with the synthesis of purines by de novo synthesis or salvage pathway. Now coming to the first enzyme, abnormal phosphoribosyl amidotransferase. This is the key enzyme of de novo synthesis of purines. It is not inhibited by nucleotides AMP and GMP, which actually inhibit this enzyme by feedback inhibition. And the second abnormal enzyme is abnormal PRPP synthetase. Due to abnormality in this enzyme, this cannot be regulated by normal allosteric regulation. This leads to increased production of PRPP, and this PRPP is utilized for the synthesis of purines by de novo synthesis. When purines availability increases, then they are subjected to increased degradation and leads to production of more amount of uric acid that leads to hyperuricemia. And the third enzyme is deficiency of enzymes of salvage pathway. This in turn leads to increased availability of PRPP, and this PRPP is again utilized for the synthesis of purines, which leads to increased degradation of purines, and finally uric acid levels increases in blood. And other enzyme is glucose 6 phosphatase deficiency. Because of this enzyme deficiency, glucose 6 phosphate cannot be converted into glucose. This is the enzyme of glycogenolysis. So due to this deficiency, glucose 6 phosphate gets accumulated and it is diverted into HMP shunt pathway, where more amount of ribose is synthesized. Ribose is utilized for the synthesis of PRPP, and in turn availability of PRPP increases. That leads to increased production of purines. Increased purines are subjected to increased degradation, and that leads to increased production of uric acid. So these are the reasons for the primary gout. Coming to secondary gout, it is due to increased production of uric acid or decreased excretion of uric acid. Increased production of uric acid is seen mainly in rapidly growing malignant tissues like leukemias, lymphomas, polycythemias, where there is increased cell turnover, which is accompanied by increased degradation of excess nucleic acids to uric acid. And this is also seen when there is increased tissue damage due to trauma, also leads to increased production of uric acid. Coming to reduced excretion, that leads to again hyperuricemia. Chronic renal failure is associated with impaired excretion of uric acid, which leads to retention of high amounts of uric acid. And the other reason is reduced excretion is also seen due to diuretics and alcohol, which leads to hyperuricemia. Coming to clinical findings of gout, you can see gouty arthritis. There is accumulation of uric acid crystals in the synovial fluid, and nephropathy. Uric acid gets accumulated in the nephrons and damages the nephrons. And there is accumulation of uric acid in the proximal interphalangeal joints. These are the important clinical findings seen in case of gout.